So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, I, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Corvo, the Loyalist Conspiracy thanks you for your work. I don't know if I can. My own brothers. We never believed that you killed the Empress. It made much more sense that the Royal Spymaster, now the Lord Regent, was behind it, aided by some of his key allies. We spent a lot of money and exposed ourselves to great risk in getting you out of prison. But we did it because we believe that you're the one that can make the difference.
Oh, and Havelock's looking for you.
Deals are made here, sometimes under the influence of wine, and sometimes the influence is the point of a knife.
All right, my friend. Martin's devised our next move. There's a footnote in Campbell's journal that tells us the Lord Regent's mistress sat for a portrait with Sokolov, the painter and royal physician. He'll be able to give us her name. Sokolov lives on Caldwin's Bridge about half the time, out over the river. The catch is that I'm afraid you've got to head out right away while Sokolov is at his apartment on the bridge. Samuel can get you close to the bridge, but you'll have to find Sokolov. Bring him back here intact, and it'll enable us to make our next move. I can't believe what you've done so far. Escaping from Coldridge, taking down the High Overseer, recovering Emily. You make this old military man proud. That's it then.
Ask me for any gear you need.
Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready. What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin's Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive, he's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready. Well, assuming, of course, you've taken care of those floodlights.
You understand now. Curfew means ain't nobody allowed to be just wandering about, except us guards.
Yeah, I know. But if we do see someone, then what? Do we say something? Remind them about curfew?
No, you don't remind them. You chase them down, and you give them a severely deadly beating, is what.
Okay, yeah, I got it. Severely deadly beating.
Citizens and visitors to our city, by order of the Regent, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens, no pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunset.
Damn you!
Citizens and visitors to our city, by order of the Regent, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens, no pedestrian movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period. Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Thank you.
smell bones in the pylons, blood beneath the stone locks. Men die building the structure.
Visitors to our city. By order of the Regent, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge until curfew is lifted. Attention all citizens. No pedestrian
movement is allowed along Caldwin's Bridge during this period.
Curfew will end tomorrow morning at sunrise.
Thank you. blasted curfew. How is anyone...
Well now, Mr. Pratchett, even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch. Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good to bait me, officer. But don't worry, I'll be fine. I'll profit. A smart man can come out ahead, even in the time of plague.
Sure, like that Sokolov. He's doing fine. Always a lot of exotic items coming and going from his place. Keeps his place running, at least for now.
Yes, yes, if by exotic you mean foul smelling as a witch's bottom. The royal physician will be fine too, until he crosses the wrong man.
Came through earlier.
charger, then left for the legal district.
Okay, good. We can't lose any more men to the ARC pilot. Touch the charger before your shift when the duty officer brings it by, and the ARC pilot will fry you. Checking out. Come out, and I'll go easy on you. It hurts. I'll feed your heart to the hounds. Firing!
Need to go up and check the whale oil?
What for? The lights are working perfect.
Well, there's nothing to do. And I like climbing the pillars.
Just leave the oil tanks. What's important to that? Watch out.
Thank you.
Someone's down.
I know you're here somewhere, scum.
I'll feed your heart.
Got you now. You gotta bleed.
Clear the line.
Here you are.
A promotion for the
master. Watch out.
Find a way to keep these rats off me so that I can get out.
The air is heavy and stale. Some acrid powder still lingers in it.
After what happened last night?
Never doubt it.
The hunt dies.
We got a prowler on the loose.
Turn my hopes and energies to Formula 25, which in conjunction with a high heat therapy, which came to me most vividly in a dream last night, has great potential according to the latest celestial alignment. As for test subject 312, after the characteristic sloughing of the skin, she should be dead.
What? How did you get past all the guards?
Your tattoo is quite unusual. It is reminiscent of markings I've studied on cave walls far from the city. Who sent you? Piero? That jealous fool. There's no need to be his lap hound. You and I can come to an agreement. One that I'm sure will please you more than anything Piero dreamed up.
I can't say I'm surprised. I knew someone would come eventually. But you're not what I expected. There's no need for violence. Great friends, you... Will you drink, sit, and talk a while? Come, we'll discuss your future, money, women, whatever you want. There is much to learn from the stars for those fluent in their tongue. I could consult my astronomical charts. Is there no reasoning with you? Before you do anything rash, I think we can come to an agreement. Two men are pursuing you. Whatever they are paying you, I will double it, triple it. No. Your money is not the only thing I have in abundance. Perhaps there are other rewards you seek. I see you are a determined man. Is there nothing I can offer you? Sir? Who are you? What is it you want? Money? Elixir against the plague? I don't know how you got past all the defenses, but I think I can assume if you wanted me dead, well, we wouldn't be having this conversation. Everything within my power to give you is yours. If you'll just let me go, I can see you are an intelligent man. So you understand there will be repercussions if you should harm me. I am the royal physician, head of the Academy of Natural Philosophy. Stay back! Have you no heart? Please! Damn it! Someone help me! No, no, no!
Whoever you are, he kept me in a cage. Like an animal. Pain is horrible right now. So I'll just hide in the corner.
Position himself. You made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off.